update, and things have been going crazy in here. I've had to make several adjustments, so I just wanted to share with you what some of those are today. So let me know if you can see me, if you can hear me. That way I know that my live stream is working here, and then we'll get started in just a few minutes with our update. So just going to refresh the chat window over here to make sure things are actually moving along. I think we are live. So let me just show you my plants, and that way you can see the progress of the growth. And let's see here. It's pretty exciting. I'm going to tip the camera down just a bit so you guys can see what's going on. So, okay, there we have it there. Okay, it looks like we've got a couple people joining us. Hi, Kieran, how are you? Thanks for joining us here. Kelly Camera Guy is helping me out in the chat from work. So thank you guys so much for joining me. Organic Gardening in North Carolina. Great, Caroline, great to see you. And what we're talking about here, for those of you just joining us, is I'm doing a little live update. Sorry, got myself half in, half out. Doing a little live update of my cucumber and tomato. I was gonna film a video, but I thought, let's just go live and have a great time with everybody on their lunch break all across America and all across the world. And I just want to show you guys how the progress of my plants, indoor plants, are doing. So thank you guys so much for joining us. Hello, Pam, how are you? And Allison, Jennifer, great to see you guys. So I was just showing everyone the plants here. And I just wanted to give you guys too a little glimpse of where I have them. I have them here in a corner in my dining room, and my little growing corner is actually expanding. Let me turn my camera around just so you guys can see. I've got some plants. I also hooked up a little shop light down there towards our sliding door with some different indoor things I'm growing. So we'll go over and check those out in just a moment. But before we do, let me give you guys a close up. I'm gonna turn around here. It's kind of a tight space, so bear with me if things are a little bit shaky. This tomato plant, I honestly, guys, I couldn't be happier with the growth. It's just growing by leaps and bounds. And what I ended up doing is I put a taller PVC pipe here because the smaller one I had, the plant was just quickly outgrowing. I was moving the clip light up till I got to the end, so I put one that's much longer, and that way it has a lot more room to grow almost to the top of the tomato cage. I can put the light way up there, so I don't know if you can see that or not, but hopefully that'll do the trick. If not, we'll just have to get a taller pole in. But what I've got going on here is, first of all, I did the fungus gnats video on Saturday, and I did see a few fungus gnats crawling around the soil here. So what I did is I put a little container of the apple cider vinegar just right here in the soil, since there's space here. Obviously, I want to be careful not to dump this over in the soil because that would not be good for the plant. But I've got my little tea light holder of the apple cider vinegar, which we talked about on the video that I released over the weekend. In case you missed that, definitely go back and watch, because fungus gnats are a huge problem for a lot of people growing indoors. With my neem oil here, my little neem oil spray. And I haven't sprinkled the surface of the soil with cinnamon yet. We did talk about that in the video, but I didn't want to do that just yet. We're going to see how the fungus gnats go. So anyway, what I have going here with the tomato plant is, when I planted this plant, it's been probably 2 to 3 weeks since I transplanted it in this Smart Pots container here. I did have two tomato plants, and I left both of them in at the time because I wanted to have a backup plan in case one of the seedlings kind of wilted and died. But at this point, they're both doing extremely well. Now, the one here on this side is doing much better. It's definitely more vigorous and getting taller. So what I'm going to actually go ahead and do today is clip this second stem out, because I don't want it, you know, really competing, you know, for the nutrients and for the growth. And I'm going to go ahead and put that in a jar of water, and it should root and hopefully form a new plant for me that I can then put out in the garden. So I'm going to go ahead and cut it out here. So don't freak out. I am going to put it to good use. It's going to definitely go to good use. Where's my pruners here? So super easy to do if you guys have this situation. You just get your pruners in here. And I'm just going to clip the stem right here. You guys can see that. Clip it off. And then this will make a new tomato plant for me. I pull it out here, and it'll definitely help this one from, you know, getting overcrowded, and hopefully it'll really help it grow more vigorously. Now, I am also going to trim off some of these bottom branches here. It's important with an indoor plant that you do keep it well pruned. Otherwise, this thing's going to be taken over my dining room, and I don't want that. I definitely want a productive plant. So pruning it will definitely help with that situation. So I'm also going to cut off these bottom stems here, or bottom branches. And I could do the same as far as rooting these and creating new plants, cloning new plants. So I'll just have to see how much room I have. I may go ahead and root those, and then we'll see how it goes from there. But I'm going to cut these three little branches off. And I will be able to take some of your questions at the end here, but I just kind of want to do this little demonstration first. So I really appreciate all you guys that are commenting in the chat room and, you know, following along in the chat and interacting with each other. And hopefully I get to see some of your questions at the end. Now, you can see here, another little pruning technique is to prune off the suckers. So you can see this little, I like to call this like the little armpit. And here we have a little sucker coming out. So I do like to keep these pruned on my indoor plants. On the outdoor plants, I don't do it as much just because I run out of time. So I'm just going to go in here and pinch this off. And that way, like I said, more of the energy will go into producing tomatoes and that kind of thing, rather than you know, keeping up with all the leafy growth. So there's a couple more in here I'm going to trim off. There's one around the back I'm going to pinch off there. Okay, so that already really helps, and I'm hoping that will help this tomato shoot up higher and then start to branch out and form some flowers. Or I'm going to move my light out of the way here just so you guys can see. So I am super excited about this. This plant is just looking so good. Look at those right there. You see those guys? There's a little flower bud starting to form. So it's super exciting. I'm just so happy with the progress of this plant. It's super green. It's looking super healthy. So far, the fungus gnats are staying away. Couldn't be happier. Now, I do get a lot of questions about watering. So let me just share with you what I do. First of all, the smart pots, I'm really thinking is the way to go for indoor growing. These guys are just doing great. Really holding on to the water well. I've got a little plastic tray underneath here. And what I do to check for watering, because overwatering is really a common problem, and it does help bring the fungus gnats on, which we don't want. So I've just been kind of putting my finger here in the soil, and it still feels pretty moist in there. So if you, you know, put your finger in here and you still feel some moistness, you really do not need to water. And I actually haven't watered this for a couple of weeks, so it's holding on to the moisture really, really well. So I couldn't be happier with that. So that's basically the progress of the tomato. And I do see a question here. What type of tomato is this? This is called a Chadwick cherry tomato. And I wanted to grow a more compact variety, number one, because the likelihood that I'll get a fruit off of this plant or a tomato off this plant is better indoors if you grow a smaller variety, because they don't need as much light, they don't need as much sunshine, that type of thing. And that way it also doesn't grow 10 feet tall and take over my whole house. So I'm hoping that that strategy works. But from what I've talked to other people that have grown tomatoes indoors, that has done really well. This is a seed from MI Gardener, and he actually told me that they were able to grow one indoors and get it to fruit last winter. So I thought I would give that a try. Now, moving on to the cucumber right next door here. And cucumber is also doing really well. I did make a couple of changes since our last video. I think I mentioned in the video, I had a really small saucer underneath here. It was one of those terracotta saucers that matched the terracotta pot. Switched it out to a larger saucer because I had a problem with the water overflowing. So I actually haven't had to water it again because, again, I've been doing the same technique, just, you know, checking the soil. And so far it's been doing pretty well. Haven't watered it for a couple of weeks, but the thing that's really exciting is this plant is absolutely loaded down with flowers. And you can see it's got little tendrils here. So the tendrils are starting to grab onto my tomato cage that I put on in last week's video. And I did, in the video I did last week, I took out the stake I had for support. I had a like a cedar pole in there, added the tomato cage, and the tomato was, or the cucumber was starting to grow kind of all down in the bottom of the container instead of up. This stretchy tie tape, and this, I love this stuff. This stuff is really, really handy. the stretchy tie tape here. You guys, a lot of you guys might already use that, but you can get it at pretty much any hardware store. This stuff absolutely works great. I love it because it's stretchy. It doesn't, you know, it stretches as the plant grows, which is really nice. So I just tied it on here, this little bamboo pole, and that way I can train the tomato or the cucumber to grow up through the tomato cage and hopefully up over the tomato cage and give me some cucumbers. So what I'm watching for, though, is the female flowers. So far, we just have the male flowers. Male flowers, which you can tell because they have little teeny tiny cucumbers behind them. So you'll see a little teeny tiny cucumber right here and then a flower attached to it. And once I see that, I can start the process of hand pollinating. So that's going to be pretty exciting because obviously inside the house, we're not going to have the pollinators and the bees flying around. So we're going to have to hand pollinate this baby to help it to produce fruit. But so far, I just have male flowers. So when I see some female flowers, I will definitely bring you guys along for that process and let you know all about the hand pollinating. But I just think this cucumber, it looks fabulous. The leaves are nice and green, and I couldn't be more pleased with the progress. So definitely we'll keep you guys posted on that. So let me just set the camera down here again and turn around and say hi to everyone once again and see if I can answer some questions about indoor growing. And then maybe I'll give you guys a little tour of what else I have here in my my little grow light dining room. I did move some things out of my grow light closet. It was getting a little warm in there for some of my cooler weather things like lettuce. I did have my indoor lettuce in there and it was just a little bit too toasty because it's a pretty enclosed space and the lettuce didn't like the heat. So I had to move them out here into my dining room. And as you guys know, I also, hopefully you know, if you watch some of my other videos, I planted a lot of other cucumbers and tomato seedlings. And I had to figure out what to do with them. So I'll show you that at the end of the video as well, what I ended up doing with those. Okay, so let me say hi to everyone in the chat. I see Cindy Moore is on here and she's saying, hi Cindy, I did finally find Kellogg's breakfast tomato seeds. Awesome. I get mine at Baker Creek Seed. I don't know where you found yours, but they have those and it's a great place to get some seeds as well. And you have them started under your grow light. Oh, that's so exciting. I actually started some myself this week and you're going to love those. I absolutely love those tomatoes. They are the best. Hi, Sister Sarah. How are you doing? And yeah, Sister Sarah is asking, will you be planting them outside when the weather permits? I'm hoping to, definitely. I definitely want to get an indoor harvest. I think that would be a lot of fun, something I've never done. I'd be really excited to get an indoor tomato and indoor cucumber. And then, yes, I do want to find a spot for them out in the garden because there's only so long I can grow them indoors. Okay. Hi, let's see. Mary from South Florida, how are you? And Joshua, how are you doing? Hello, Kim from Pam and Jackson McGee. Wow, Pam, so great to see you. And Jackson, Wendy Price, great to see you guys too. So comment below in the chat if you guys are growing indoors still or if you're starting your seeds and getting ready for warm weather planting. Super fun. It's been warm here in Southern California for the past couple of days. We actually almost hit 80 degrees yesterday. So that literally felt like a heat wave. Rod, how are you doing from Baja? I bet it's getting cold or warm there in Baja as well. Midwest Mountain Home and Garden, do you find your seed germination, whoops, scrolled up there, rates to be better indoors under those grow lights with a controlled climate or better outside under natural conditions? Well, definitely with tomatoes and cucumbers, I found that I do like to get them started inside under, you know, the controlled conditions and get them to be a nice, good size. And then I like to move them out in the garden. I find they get a really good, strong, healthy start that way, and they usually perform better outside. Cucumbers have had better luck with getting them to germinate outside, but tomatoes really do better when I start them indoors. Okay, let's see. Jane Perry, you're watching from Maine. Awesome. You inspire me. Oh, thank you so much, Jane. I'm really glad to hear that. I really appreciate you sharing. And it's really fun to hear that because it really helps keep me motivated and just keep making the garden content. So I'm really, really glad to hear that. And Pam is starting seeds for warmer weather. I know it's a lot of fun to think and dream about the warm weather garden starting soon. Spring is gearing up. I've got some warm weather seeds started myself as well. And it's going to be a lot of fun. Now, let me show you guys over here what I have going on. And then I'll take you outside on my patio and show you a couple things I have out there. Get my shoes back on because I was sitting here on the floor. Over here, I set up a little grow station, kind of a little Mickey Mouse thing, but it was the best solution that I had that I could do quickly. I've got actually the same shop light that I have in my grow light closets. I had an extra one, and I thought, why not just use the same little idea of getting the milk? Not a super professional, you know, grow light station or shelf or anything, but hey, it does the job. I got these plants under light for me, which is exactly what I needed. So here I had some lettuce seedlings started. Like I said, it was getting a little bit warm in my grow closets, and these are doing much better out here already. Got some more lettuce there, got some microgreens, some Mizuna mustard, and some type of lettuce right there, and then some little teeny tiny lettuce seedlings. So pretty much doing the trick for me, and I really noticed an improvement yesterday after I pulled them out of my grow light closet. They just kind of perked back up. It was just too warm for them in there. So right next door there, I've got my grow light box, which is always a good old faithful grow light box. And inside of that, I have some warm weather seedlings started. I think I've got some tomatoes and some kale and maybe some basil started in there. So this is my old faithful. I love this grow light box, and you can see things are kind of taking over my little dining room area here. Tomato and cucumber seedlings. I started a whole bunch to make sure I had plenty for my indoor growing project. So let's go out here to the table on the deck. I'm actually getting these hardened off, kind of transitioning them to outdoors, because I did get a little mini outdoor greenhouse, which we weren't able to get set up over the weekend because it was super windy. So it needs transplant. It's kind of starting to wilt there. Some basil and some of my other cucumbers that I started indoors. So I'm going to leave these out here for a couple of hours to get them kind of acclimated, and then I'm going to move them inside, because you don't want to put them all outdoors at once. We don't want to shock their system. So they're not used to the great, you know, the sunlight, so they have to get used to it gradually. So let's see. Oh, hey, Tara, how's it going? You're starting your peppers and eggplants tomorrow once the new greenhouse arrives. How cool. Great. So you're getting a little mini greenhouse too. So that'll be a lot of fun to get those outside. It's always fun to get spring plants started. Okay, are you going to grow melons again from Animal Bay? Yes, I definitely plan on growing melons. I'm hoping to grow some larger melons this year. Last year I grew some more compact varieties. So I've been working on my soil over the winter time and getting it all, you know, some real good organic nutrients in there. So hopefully my large melons will have the nutrients they need for the summertime. So, oh, bad connection, try to stand still. Okay, maybe it's because I went outdoors. Okay, have you ever considered a DIY worm bin? Wanda. Hi, Wanda. Yes, I actually do have a couple of videos on that. I don't have one going right now, but I am going to be doing some videos in the next few weeks on using worm castings and worm tea in your garden. So super great organic nutrients to add to your soil and to fertilize your plants with. So I'll be giving some more information about that coming very soon. So you guys, thank you so much. Oh, I saw one more question. Can you make a video on how to acclimate plants? I actually do have a video on that, Animal Bay. It's called How to Transition Your Plants to the Outdoors. So you wanna go back and check that out. But most likely as part of our spring garden series, I'll be doing another video on that as well. So. Okay, I do have a series, Mia, on how to start your garden. You want to go back and watch the $10 Garden series from a year ago or so. It's called the $10 Garden series, and it's pretty much how to start a garden or how to grow a spring garden from start to finish. So go check that out. But we are getting ready to start our $10 Garden series season 2 here in a couple of weeks. Definitely make sure you stay tuned for that. So you guys, thank you so much for joining me today. Hope you enjoyed the little update on my indoor tomato and indoor cucumber plants. Hope your garden is going well, and I really appreciate you guys joining me. It's always so much fun on these live streams. I literally feel like I am just sitting in the garden chatting with some of my garden friends. So it's really a lot of fun to share the tips and the tricks with each other and to learn from each other. So guys, thank you so much, and I will see you guys on the next video. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.